Let's take another look at the acorn woodpecker pecking. As it pecks, what happens is it starts with its head back away from the tree, and then its head speeds up and accelerates, and then when it hits the tree, it decelerates. And the impact force depends on how quickly the brain stops when the beak hits the tree. So we need to understand something about acceleration and deceleration to understand the forces on impact. One simple example is to think about what happens if you take an egg and you just drop it and it hits the floor. As you release the egg, right at that very moment, it's got zero speed. And as it falls, it's gaining speed. And we say that the egg is accelerating with 1g, so g is for gravity. And then when the egg hits the floor, there's some impact, the deceleration will be many more times than 1g. So if we think about brain injury, what sort of decelerations can the brain withstand before there's some sort of injury? Well, people have studied this quite extensively for humans, and they found that the human brain can tolerate decelerations up to about 100g, or 100 times the acceleration of gravity. So one question is, how much acceleration or deceleration could a woodpecker brain withstand without injury? And in the next segment, we're going to look at how people have measured the deceleration in the woodpecker during pecking.